Hi everyone, this is the Submo English Club channel. A warming welcome to the podcast series, accompanying you to set a perspective in life. And I'm Kim Fu, coming to the topic, future and coming of age. Today, we will talk about better be alone than in ill company. You know, if you felt something that carries everything you expect from trust, this might be reliable. Because reliable people are like a compass that helps to navigate us in the endless ocean. So, do you know those who are mentioning our topic today? And it's not anyone's strength, but our friends who are always with us in our own life. As a natural principle, humans cannot be born and grow when living separately from the community. At a very early age, people have connected to surrounding people so they can assimilate into life. When growing up, their relationships are more expanding and diversifying. In other words, they are more complicated. In particular, there are many kinds of friends, childhood friends, bosom friends, schoolmates, and some kinds of that. Some friends are our companion in our whole life. Even these friends may be closer than some family relationships. And they are soulmates who cares and understand us the most. Moreover, we are always affected by people and the habitats around us. And when interacting with them for a long time, we must find ways to blend in and let ourselves adjust to adapt like an empty painting would be drawn with vivid colors. And the problem is, do we become better? Our characteristic will unintentionally get more negative in this environment with these people, won't it? Therefore, choosing friends is a crucial thing. Suppose people do not know how to look at behavior to guess and make a preliminary assessment of nature. In that case, they will be easily exploited and bullied by the bad guy, or at least be led and oriented by having no ability to distinguish what is right, what is wrong, or what is good or bad. Besides, people also be foolish and gradually become passive, just waiting to be instructed and not having independent thinking. However, they are not only very fond of showing themselves well, but also want to be recognized by others, and become aggressive towards those who displease them. On the contrary, if we observe and choose friends carefully, we pay more attention to quality instead of quantity. True friends will get each other to develop and improve our downsides, as well as have more opportunities to build good long-term relationships. And check a bag that who you spend time with in college is the most important decision that any student can make on campus. You become the people you surround yourself with, he explained. By the importance of choosing friends when we were still very little, older adults taught us some relevant lessons. So, let's begin with, bad behavior does not say anything about the nature of the people. Every problem has some roots. Is it advisable to think carefully, to understand each aspect of it thoroughly? We cannot regard our friends as being evil and deny all of their good things just because they do one thing wrong. This is unfair, not understanding, and not grasping nature. In addition, be honest and remind your friends when they make mistakes. Don't mince words to please your friends. Is it so harmful not only to your friends, but also to yourself? And the last one is that, friends might be loyal. But what is loyal? Is it to be with your friends when they have difficulty or make mistakes, remind them of their doing wrong, learn their goodness, and be happy when they are successful? In reality, however, relationships are more challenging to handle than just listening to and memorizing parents' instructions. Is it easy to understand that giving up real-life relationships is not as simple as a click on Facebook? Especially sometimes when we go to work in the future, we will often interact with the boss and other colleagues. If we want to break up a relationship with someone, is it okay for us to come in front of them and say, "I don't want to be friends with you anymore"? It's not necessary to do that. All we need to do is limit our time contacting them. If we meet them, we just say something to show respect. You can find someone more suitable to establish a relationship. Find another friend to play with, or even to be alone if you feel yourself is your best friend. Because these negative, disparaging people are spiritually mentors like the Dementors, the hideous gods of Azkaban in Harry Potter. That is to say, when hearing those people, you immediately feel scared and bored. When they are with you, you feel exhausted.
And you, how do you feel about that? Do you often face those spiritual Dementors mentioned above on Facebook or anyone about you? If the answer is yes, you should fire all the people instead of them. Because we do not have the right to choose where we were born, but we can choose friends. The only one who has the right to do that is you.
After all, if you do not want to interfere with your future, I have advice for you. You have to get good eyes, which are suitable for finding good friends, because your friends are one of the elements that make your future successful. Thank you for listening. We hope that what we have shared today can help you get an overview of Better Be Alone Than In Ill Company. And we wish you to find your true friends always ready for you.